to start with today's news. Supreme Court Collegium reconsiders transfer of judges to Madhya Pradesh High Court, shifts them to Telangana. This comes under GS2 Judiciary. For prelims, you need to study about the collegium system. So, collegium system is the system of appointment and transfer of judges. And that this actually this process is evolved through the judgments only. It is not by an act of parliament or not by any provision of the constitution. Remember, it is done through the judgment. And this collegium system is headed by Chief Justice of India and comprises four other senior most judges of the court. And judges of higher judiciary are appointed only through the collegium system, and the government has a role only after names have been decided by the collegium. And National Judicial Appointment Committee was thought of a replacement of collegium system, but it was invalidated by the Supreme Court itself. That is also a judgment. So when it comes to judicial appointment, the role of the government is very limited, and it can only get an inquiry that conducted by Ministry of Home if a lawyer is to be elevated as a judge in a High Court or the Supreme Court. So which means there is no very limited role of the government when it comes to appointment. And the government can even raise objection and seek clarification regarding the collegium choices. But if the collegium reiterates the same name, the government is bound under the constitutional bench judgments to appoint them as a judges. And the constitutional provisions is there for the appointment of judge. According to Article 124 Clause 2 says that the judges should be appointed by the president by warrant under his hand and seal after the consultation with the Supreme Court judges and also the High Court in the states if it is necessary. Okay, and Article 217 says every judge of High Court shall be appointed by the president after consultation with the Chief Justice of India, State Governor, and in case of appointment of judge other than Chief Justice, then they must be consulted with Chief Justice of the High Court. So Forest Bill goes to the House, that is unchanged. So this comes under GS1 Geography, and this is a Forest Bill. So for prelims about forest, it present in India there is no clear nationally accepted definition of forest. States are responsible for determining their definition of forest. Forests are included in the concurrent list of the Constitution, and through the 42nd Amendment Act 1976, forest and protection of wild animals and birds were transferred from state to concurrent list. Article 51A Clause G states that it shall be the fundamental duty of every citizen to protect and improve the natural environment, and Article 48A in DPSP states that state shall endeavor to protect and improve the environment. So according to the India State of Forest Report 2019, tree and forest cover together made up of 24.56 of area, and we have a long term goal of having 33% of forest cover, but we yet to achieve this goal. India's forests are currently governed by National Forest Policy 1988. So in Varanasi, turtles help clean the Ganga. This comes under GS3 Environment. So Namami Clean Program, Ganga Program, is an integrated conservation mission approved as a flagship program by Union Government. It has accomplished the objective of clearing the pollution, also conserving and rejuvenating the Ganga River, and it is operated under Ministry of Jal Shakti. The program is implemented by the National Mission for Clean Ganga, which is the implementation wing of National Ganga Council. Okay. So Ganga River system actually called the Bhagirathi, and it is joined by Alaknanda and Devprayag in Uttarakhand. At Haridwar, Ganga emerges from the mountain to the plains. Ganga is joined by many tributaries such as Yamuna, Ghagra, Gandak and Koshi. Thank you.